In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Do good, O Lord, to those who have held fast in your name. Those who turn aside to their crooked ways. Let us confess our sins to God, our Father. O Lord, have mercy upon us, poor, miserable sinners. We have offended you in thought, word, and deed. We have sinned against our neighbor. Spare us, O God, who confesses to you and who hide not our faults from your eyes. Restore the penitent and forgive us all our sins. According to the promise of your mercy, revealed to us in Jesus Christ our Lord. As he suffered and died to cover our sins, cover us with his righteousness, and grant us grace that today and every day we live upright, sober, and godly lives to the glory of your holy name. Amen. God in his mercy has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all your sins. Through the mercy of God in Christ Jesus, our Savior, you have been made children of God in baptism and live because of his mercy. As a called and ordained servant of Christ and by his authority and in his stead, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May he who has begun this good work within you bring it to completion on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Peace be with you. Oh, give thanks to the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. Sing to him. Sing praises to him. Tell of his wondrous works. Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Seek the Lord and his strength. Seek his presence continually. Remember the wondrous works that he has done, his miracles and the judgments he shuddered. O offspring of Abraham, his servant, children of Jacob, his chosen ones. O give thanks unto the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among all people. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. We pray. Mighty God, your love once called a people and made them your chosen instrument, from which you would bring forth your Son. Grant us that same love and grace, that we might be your own and live under you in your kingdom forevermore. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated. The Old Testament lesson for today comes from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, beginning with verse 6. And here, because the Lord loves you, he has chosen you to be his treasured possession. For you are a people holy to the Lord your God. The Lord your God has chosen you to be a people for his treasured possession. Out of all the peoples who are on the face of the earth, it was not because you were more in number than any other people that the Lord set his love on you and chose you, for you were the fewest of all people. But it was because the Lord loves you and is keeping the oath that he swore to your fathers, that the Lord has brought you out with a mighty hand and redeemed you from the house of slavery, from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Know, therefore, that the Lord your God is God, the faithful God, who keeps his covenant and steadfast love with those who love him and keeps his commandments to 1,000 generations. This is the word of the Lord. The epistle lesson for today comes from Romans chapter 8, which will serve as our sermon text for today. And in this selection, Paul tells us that nothing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Savior. And we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good, for those who are called according to his purpose. For those whom he foreknew, he also predestined to be conformed to the image of his Son, in order that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those whom he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those whom he justified, he also glorified. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who could be against us? He who did not spare his own Son, but gave him up for us all, how will he not also with him graciously give us all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of God? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or danger or sword? As it is written, for your sakes we are being killed all day long. We are regarded as sheep to be slaughtered. No. In all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord. We rise for the verse and the gospel lesson for today. Alleluia. I will open my mouth in parables. I will utter what has been hidden since the foundation of the world. Alleluia. The Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 13th chapter. And here in our gospel lesson for today, we see that the kingdom of God is like a hidden treasure. The kingdom of heaven is like a hidden, like a treasure hidden in a field, which a man found and covered up. Then he, in joy, goes and sells all that he has and buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a merchant in search of fine pearls, who, on finding one pearl of great value, went and sold all that he had and bought it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net that was thrown into the sea and gathered fish of every kind. When it was full, men drew it ashore and sat down and sorted the good into containers, but threw away the bad. So it will be at the close of the age. The angels will come out and separate the evil from the righteous and throw them into the fiery furnace. In that place, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. Have you understood all these things? They said to him, yes. And he said to them, therefore, every scribe who has been trained in the kingdom for the kingdom of heaven is like a master of the house who brings out of his treasure what is new and what is old. This is the gospel of the Lord. You may be seated for our hymn of the day, When Peace Like a River. Grace, mercy, and peace be multiplied unto you from our Lord, from our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. The text for our meditation, as I said, is from our gospel lesson from the Book of Romans, the 8th chapter, as Paul continues with 35 to 39. In the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, fellow redeemed, the symphony of confidence Paul has written so far in the 8th chapter of Romans comes to a grand crescendo in the words of today's text. And to understand their full power, we must remind ourselves of what has come before. Listen to the notes of assurance struck by the apostle, inspired by the Holy Spirit. In verse 1, Paul says, "Therefore, there is no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus." Verse 2, "Therefore, through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit of life set me free from the law of sin and death." He goes on in verse 14, "Those who are led by the Spirit of God are the sons of God." Verse 18, "I consider that the present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us." Verse 26, "The Spirit helps us in our weakness. We do not know what we ought to pray for, but the Holy Spirit himself intercedes for us with groans that words cannot express." Verse 28, "In all things God works for good to those who love him, who has been called according to his purpose." And verse 29 and 30, "For those God foreknew, he predestined to be conformed to the likeness of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brothers. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified." And then he comes with that question in verse 31. "If God is for us, who can be against us?" Following that question, Paul asks another question. "Who shall separate us from the love of Christ?" Perhaps some of you think way back now, as I look over the audience, me too, what friends wrote in your yearbook in high school. Some wrote this, which I never heard of it, I came across it, "Yours till Niagara Falls." Have you ever heard that? Okay, I didn't. But when you wrote that, if you were serious when you wrote it, you were just not playing with the words. You really meant yours forever. Now, in that last century, a group of spectators gathered at Niagara Falls to marvel its majesty and its power. The water roared over the precipice and crashed down to the rocks below. I haven't seen that yet. The waters thundered so loudly, and I've seen that in other waterfalls, but perhaps it was louder at the Niagara Falls, the tourists could barely hear one another, even if they shouted comments of awe and appreciation. And then suddenly, the roar ceased. There was a dead, eerie silence fell like a wet blanket over the crowd. Somewhere upstream, on a cold winter's day, several large ice floes had come together in just the right way that temporarily blocked the flow of Niagara Falls, of the river. And these ice floes had literally turned off Niagara Falls. But no one and nothing has the power to divert the flow of God's love into our lives through Jesus Christ. God's love, established forever in Christ's death for our sins, has no limits. It's yours till Niagara Falls, and after Niagara Falls is no more. Now, we may believe in general that nothing can separate us from the love of God. But when we run into Pacifics, when we find ourselves shaken, where there's trouble, hardship, famine, nakedness, financial crisis, plant closings, downsizing, coronavirus, and our country's unrest as it's going right now. The added dangers believers face for persecution for the sake of Jesus, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Christ who loved us. We are sure of God's mercy, come what may. And our final triumph in Christ through all, not just some, of these things we triumph. Yes, our triumph is in Christ. Not through some, but of the things that we triumph, we overconquer. We are overwhelmingly conquer. Already in this life, our victory belongs to us. Victory that is total. Victory that is complete. And so it's overwhelmingly victorious. Is to be completely victorious, to have complete victory over. With that hymn writer in the hymn For All the Saints that we sang yesterday at Charles Timm's funeral. Part of the verse goes like this, that illustrates that overwhelming victory that is ours. And when the strife is fierce and the warfare long, steals on the ear the distant triumph song, and the hearts are brave again and arms are strong, alleluia, alleluia. No matter how forcefully Satan accuses you and me, even the worst sins, he cannot and will not defeat us. Since on that cross, we find that Christ defeated them. We are already participating in that triumph. We now have that peace that our sins are forgiven. Faith in Jesus Christ is the victory that overcomes the world. Many times, when we feel like we're overwhelmed and fearful, our doubts come from uncertainty about what may happen in the future. When Abraham Lincoln was riding from town to town in Illinois as a circuit riding lawyer, he often had to forge dangerous rivers. One of those was the Fox River, noted for the danger was particularly life-threatening. And one evening, he met an indigent Methodist preacher who asked him if he discovered a safe way to cross the Fox River. And Abraham Lincoln said, yes, I learned that the greatest secret about crossing the Fox River is I never crossed the Fox River until I reached the Fox River. What rivers are you crossing today? What rivers do you fear you will face tomorrow? You see, Paul's confidence words are your words too. I am convinced that nothing in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Not even the Jordan River, often symbolic to death, can daunt us. God once led the children of Israel across that Jordan River on dry land. Israel crossed that Jordan on dry land, but there was many worried in advance of how they could do it. But just as they just followed the Ark of the Covenant, that river stopped for the Lord's Ark. They never even got their feet wet. Remember one of the hymns that we sing, Guide Me Ever, Great Redeemer? One of the verses goes like this, When I tread the verge of Jordan, bid my anxious fears subside. Death of death and hell's destruction, land me safe on Canaan's side. During the end of, or towards the end of his life, the painter Winroy had difficulty in holding his paintbrushes because he had crippling arthritis, and it threatened to steal his ability to paint even at all. And a fellow artist asked him, "Why do you paint despite the pain?" And Renoir replied, "The pain passes, but the beauty remains." May this be our thought, too, as we experience the trials in our life and the tribulations that come our way, with that sure and certain hope that we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding keep your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. We rise for the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We pray. Lord of mercy, hear our prayers for your people who call upon you in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Almighty God, your love once created all things and set apart people of your promise. Grant us faith that we may believe your word, heed the call of your love, and find peace in your gift of salvation. Lord, in your mercy. Blessed Father, your love is our great treasure, and your kingdom your gift. Grant that we both, with a bold voice, make known your salvation to all the ends of the earth. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful God, you established your church and endowed her with your word and your sacraments. Bless all pastors and missionaries as they serve us in your name with your gifts and grace. Lord, in your mercy. Almighty God, you have set before us leaders who exercise the authority of state for our protection against enemies and for justice against evildoers. Bless our president, our Congress of the United States, and all who make and minister and judge our laws. Lord, in your mercy. Compassionate God, your Son was wounded for our transgressions, and in his wounds we are healed and have strength. Hear us on behalf of all the sick, of those who suffer and grieving and dying, especially Norma, Clara and Bob, Jackie, Sam, James, Elise, Gary, Harold, Hannah Grace, Carol, Jake, Marcy, Karen, Amy, Elise, Loretta, Jackie, Bill and Lillian, Eliza Rose, Darlene, Carolyn, Florence, Richard, Nancy, Linda, Dawn, Eleanor, Gloria, Bill and Annabelle, Dee and Robin, Charlene, Maria, Bill, Sandy, and Mildred. And we ask you, dear Lord, to grant them all that is needed to support them in this hour of need. Lord, in your mercy. God of grace, you have given to us the gift of work and the privilege of using the fruits of our labors for the support of our families and ourselves. Give us a generous heart that we give aid to the poor and honor to you with the worship of our hearts and the tithes and offerings of our hands. Lord, in your mercy. Blessed Lord, your Son has set his table before us and offers to us his flesh as our food and blood as our drink. Give us hearts of faith and fill us with repentance that we may receive from him we keep faithfully until that day when we join all your saints to rejoice in your presence on high, Lord, in your mercy. And Lord, we ask you to continue to be with all of those who are suffering from the virus, and as it is having another siege, we ask you, dear Lord, to be with those who are trying to find a cure. Give healing to those who are sick and patience to those who are experiencing that. We also recognize the unrest in our cities. We ask you, dear Lord, to bring peace to the hearts of people. We ask you that that heart will be also with forgiveness and love to each other. Lord, in your mercy. Bless our congregation, dear Lord, the staff, the council, the call committee. We ask you to be with them as they do their work among us, so that we might continue to grow in your faith and love as we serve you in your kingdom. And we ask you, dear Lord, in time to give us a faithful pastor in which will serve us and lead us and guide us. Lord, in your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, and trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. At this time, we remember the offerings that we would be taking as an act of worship, and we thank you for those gifts, and we encourage you to continue to support the work of the church, both here in Ascension and elsewhere as well. So we remain seated for our offertory. We rise. The Lord be with you.
And also
you. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is our privilege and delight to offer you our thanks and praise, O Lord, through Jesus Christ, whom you have sent to be our Savior and Redeemer. He is your Son, born among your chosen people, to fulfill the law and the prophets. And with them we rejoice in the treasure of your love and lift our voices in song of your people and the angels on high, praising you and singing. Almighty God, from nothing you made all things to be, and in your mercy you created the children of men for your glory. When by sin we were lost to you and marked for death, you gave us your promise and raised us to hope again. In your love manifested through the ages by the voice of the prophets, you revealed to us the salvation accomplished by your Son, born in the flesh. He suffered and was died in our place to save us. Gather now in his name to receive the new covenant of his body and blood. We pray to you to grant your Holy Spirit that we may eat and drink in faith. Our Lord Jesus Christ, the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given to you. This do in remembrance of me." And in the same manner also, he took the cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the new testament of my blood, which is shed for you for the remission of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Recalling all that your Son accomplished for us by his holy life and the life-giving death and living by his resurrection, we pray you to keep us in this faith until that day when we and all who have died in Christ shall live in the presence and feast upon the marriage supper of the Lamb in the kingdom forevermore. In God's name, in the Savior's name, and as he has taught us, we are bold to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Savior's body and his blood strengthen and preserve you in the true faith until life everlasting. Depart in peace. Amen. We rise. We pray. O Lord, you have richly fed us with the holy gifts of your body and blood in this bread and wine. Keep us by your Spirit's power that we not depart from Christ, but be brought into the eternal joy of your kingdom and in the blessed reunion of the saints before your glorious presence. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, ever one God, life without end. Let us bless the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you peace. Go in peace and serve the Lord. I have one announcement, or not announcement, but a thank you. Today is Stephanie's, I think, last Sunday. And she's been on that soundboard a long time. And we want to say thank you for all that you have done. And we hope that you continue to, I'm not going to call it retirement. I hope not. But anyway, that you enjoy your time off for a while. And God bless. And thank you again for everything. I will close with the last hymn.